as turf researchers, we consistently work with field managers at the NFL and the collegiate level, and we just heard these anecdotal stories about how certain colors would affect their end zones and their logos in different fashions, and those differences usually were dependent totally upon color. When we see these decreased quality in turf in the end zones, and even death sometimes in end zones and logo areas, it certainly can be expensive to replace those areas. So in terms of the different ACC colors, what we are finding is causing this effect is the different wavelengths of light that either are reflected or absorbed by the pigments in the paint itself. And just as our eyes perceive different colors when light is reflected into our eyes, the plants utilize these different wavelengths of light, and depending on the lighter colors being able to reflect more of that light is available for plant photosynthesis, where the darker colors that selectively absorb the important wavelengths of photosynthetically active radiation in the pigments themselves, that light is now unavailable to the plant for photosynthesis. Here at the NC State University Phytotron, we have these controlled environment growth chambers where we can plant our different painted treatments of grass. And what we can measure with this light core machine, under controlled light, controlled temperature, controlled moisture, we can actually measure how much carbon dioxide is being taken in by the plant, with the idea that the less carbon dioxide being taken in by the plant, the less that plant is actively photosynthesizing as a result of the color of paint that is being applied to that turf. Here in the lab, we can actually measure what wavelengths of light are being reflected, transmitted, and absorbed by the various colors of paint with this spectroradiometer, which looks at the particular wavelengths, the 400 to 700 nanometer wavelengths that are visible to our human eye and that are important for photosynthetically active radiation in the plant. And we can actually document which paint color is having the least and the most impact on that light that is used by the plant for photosynthesis. When you get to high schools and middle schools and parks and recs, oftentimes they don't have the money to re-sod end zones and logos, which kind of begun the idea of this research of perhaps we could come up with some ways to prevent that damage.